Hello and welcome to the award-winning Waterman Wellness, your pathway to health and wellness with local experts as your guides. I'm Lisa Kreitz. We have a lot of great information in this month's episode, including: did you know advanced clinical trials for the treatment of cancer are available here in Lake County? You'll find out how the decision to have breast reduction surgery can help alleviate pain and improve your quality of life. And you'll want to stay tuned for our visit to the Conry Creation Health Center, where you'll find out about foods that help you stick to your New Year's resolution to lose weight. Our first story offers important information for expectant parents. Medical experts want new moms to know what to expect during delivery so that once in labor, both mom and baby are healthy and safe. Samantha Linton's obstetrician was ready for the first-time mom who tested positive for group B strep, or baby strep as it's often called. According to her doctor, the commonly occurring infection doesn't typically affect new moms, but can be harmful to the baby.
I tested positive for the strep B. So I already knew that when I came in for delivery, I was gonna have to be put on antibiotics. When my water broke, I didn't really know my water broke. It wasn't like in the movies where it's like, you know, a gush. So I worked all day and I came up and told the doctor and the nurses, I said, I think it might have broke. She ended up getting an infection. Her white blood cell count was very, very high. Actually, the pediatrician on duty said it was the highest she's ever seen. So when we realized that, I mean, obviously that, you know, scared us.
The baby lives in an amniotic sac or a big water balloon, which is both protective from trauma and also infection. When this breaks, it's usually the initial onset of labor. Now this can be obvious with lots of fluid leaking, or it could be a slow trickle that just persists throughout the day.
The Florida Hospital Waterman medical team decided to keep the baby under close watch at the Center for Women and Children.
She was here in the hospital for 14 days so that they could give her antibiotics to make sure that she went home healthy. It was hard because you think you're bringing your baby home 2 or 3 days after she's born and you're not. I wouldn't have had any other doctor, wouldn't have had it any other way. So he makes you feel very comfortable. The nurses, like I can't even explain how I get a little emotional. Just how like helpful they were and made you feel like family. So I wouldn't want my sick baby anywhere else. So it was a really good experience. They called themselves her aunties.
Dr. Holland says it's important for new moms to discuss the signs of the beginning of labor with their doctors.
If at all you feel that your water is broken, it's always best to call and be evaluated as soon as there's any sort of suspicion, because time is crucial. You have a 24-hour period usually after the time your water breaks for the delivery of the baby, so that's why it's imperative.
Expecting parents can take advantage of prenatal classes which provide valuable insight into baby's delivery as well as how to take care of your newborn. Visit fhwaterman.com for more information about upcoming classes. In other news, it's almost February, so that means it's time to educate the public about the leading cause of death for men and women, heart disease. February is National Heart Month, and Florida Hospital Waterman is planning a number of events to address prevention, as well as medical advances to help cardiac patients. 1 in 4 women in the U.S. die from heart disease. The Women's Hot Topic Breakfast on February the 5th at the Tavares Pavilion on the Lake will feature local medical experts sharing insights that can help save lives. The event is free, but registration is required. We know what you eat can have a positive impact on heart health. Learn the best way to tempt your taste buds and take care of your ticker at Cooking for a Healthy Heart class on February the 17th. And Dr. Miguel Bryce will lead an educational seminar on Thursday, February the 25th at 1 p.m. The topic is irregular heartbeats and medical advances to treat them. The community is invited to attend any or all events. Just please RSVP by calling the number on your screen or visit fhwatermanheart.com. Next, we turn our focus to the cure for cancer. Local medical experts are excited about the advances that clinical trials available right here in Lake County offer in improving cancer survivability.
If you look at our advances in oncology in the last 10 years, they've been tremendous. And I can tell you that the average is around maybe 6 to 10% of patients who are eligible for trials are being enrolled in trials in the United States. And we have access to at least 10 to 15 trials here in Lake County. These are local trials. These are trials that are not only nationwide, these are worldwide trials that we are part of. We had patients that participated in clinical trial that approved at least more than 50% of the drugs that have been approved in treating cancer in the last 10 years.
Dr. Hussein stresses that clinical trials are developed with patient safety in mind.
I'm the principal investigator for our lung cancer trials in our practice in the North region, so I can tell you it's very extensive training you go through. They always remind us that you have to make sure your number one priority is the patient to be safe, because sometimes you're starting drugs or medication that you don't know how they work. So you have to make sure that you're very vigilant about any possible side effect that can happen in the patient. There are a lot of stories about patients who have cancers at end stages. They were desperate, nothing else to do. They tried everything. Then this was trial drug that they went on, and that drug made him stay alive for maybe 5 or 10 years. This happened. When you go through a trial, you can have access to drugs that are very promising that are not in the market yet. So that probably might be the only way you can get access to these drugs. One of those drugs is an immune therapy that is approved now for melanoma. It has very promising results in kidney cancer. We believe it also has promising results in lung cancer. Clinical trials don't only help the patient, they help other people, they help us learn more about the cancer. And they are definitely one of the major reasons why we are better in fighting cancer and why people are now living longer.
You can learn more about cancer treatment options by visiting the website fhwatermancancer.com. It's time to take a short break, but we'll have plenty more when Waterman Wellness continues. We'll visit the Conry Creation Health Center kitchen, where we'll meet some new faces and learn a recipe that may help you stick to your New Year's resolution. Arthritis sufferers will learn about treatments that can help alleviate pain thanks to early detection. And a local woman explains how the decision to have breast reduction surgery changed her life. You'll find additional health and wellness information in Waterman Wellness Magazine. Visit watermanwellness.com to arrange for home delivery. And you'll also find a listing of the specialists featured in this month's episode. First, Waterman Wellness has information about community events that can help you or a loved one. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the award-winning Waterman Wellness, your pathway to healthy living with help from local experts. I'm Lisa Kreitz. Our next story focuses on women's health and what may seem like an unlikely source of pain. But it is something many women suffer through.
You know, I will experience the neck pain. You know, it was like a pulling sensation. But from there, then it will go to my upper back and my shoulders. It was just terrible.
Laura Fernandez of Apopka says visits to the chiropractor and even physical therapy didn't help. She finally sought relief from Bosshart and Marzec Plastic Surgery Associates.
Anybody who has double D or larger breast often will have signs of neck pain, shoulder pain, upper back pain. They get shoulder notches, which are very painful. They get chafing underneath the breast, especially in the summer here in Florida. The first thing we'll do is evaluate to see if A, indeed, she is a candidate for breast reduction, and then B, whether it's considered medically necessary or cosmetic.
Fernandez was thrilled to know the procedure was deemed medically necessary and would be covered by insurance. She was also relieved once the surgery was explained.
The breasts are skin appendages, which means that they don't have the degree of pain sensitivity and pain fibers that you find with operations that are done in internal body cavities. They usually go home the day of the surgery. They're rarely taking prescription pain medications for more than 2 or 3 days. And a very common observation when they come in the office is, gee, this didn't hurt nearly as bad as I thought it would.
Health, being healthy, it's just unbearable. You cannot trade that for anything. And for me, the fact that I can share with my friends, that I can obviously spend time with my husband doing all the activities, like playing volleyball, like going out, right at the beach, you know, all these different things that I would love to do. So I'm able now to do it, and I just feel great.
It's the single one operation that I think comes closest to a nearly 100% success rate in relieving symptoms. The most common thing patients tell me after the operation is they wish they'd done this years ago.
You can visit watermanwellness.com to find a specialist to answer questions you may have about breast reduction surgery. Our next story is about a painful condition that affects 1 in 5 adults. And while many think arthritis is a disease of the elderly, it can affect people of all ages. Arthritis sufferers often limit their physical activity, which can lead to other health issues. Now, medical experts tout advanced treatments that can relieve the pain without procedures that provide a quicker recovery and can be done right here in Lake County.
There's a procedure now where it's a completely non-invasive, and it's not a knee replacement, but there is a type of procedure. It's a chondroplasty type of procedure where you actually inject the bone underlying the arthritis. This is something that you can offer the patient, and even if it works 70-80% of the time, it may alleviate the necessity of proceeding with a partial knee replacement or a total knee replacement. So some of these procedures are outpatient procedures. Some of the procedures can actually be done in the office.
Dr. Perry says diagnosis of arthritis has improved, which can help avoid extensive damage to the joints.
With MRIs, you can actually see arthritis developing below the joint surface. It would be like if you did an ultrasound in an area and you say, well, there's a potential sinkhole under the street. Now, on the street, you don't see it, but they have testing to see that. So, for instance, if a patient is having pain, you don't really see a lot of arthritis. You may scope their knee and may not see a lot of arthritis, but you already have that information from the MRI. You can do the subchondral injections that actually may be able to give them some period of pain relief, so they may be able to put off a partial knee or a total knee replacement. And the thing is, the procedures are getting better.
If you or a loved one needs relief from joint pain, visit the website, fhwatermanortho.com, to find a specialist who can help. Next, we head to the Conry Creation Health Center kitchen, where Caroline Rowland is with the Florida Hospital Waterman team to explain how to stick to resolutions you may have about eating healthier.
If you're like many, the new year means motivation to losing weight after eating way too much over the holidays. Now, eating less is key to that success, of course, but we know that can be hard when we're feeling hungry all the time. Now, right now, we're joined with Florida Hospital Waterman's executive chef, David Atkinson, and Creation Health Director Candace Huber. And Candace, you have a recipe for us and some tips on how to achieve that success. What are we cooking today?
It's going to be wonderful. We have a beet carrot salad, which will answer many of these points that you brought out.
Yeah, it's a super simple salad. It's got fresh apples, beets, carrots, green onions, walnuts, dill and parsley, and then a simple dressing made with salt, pepper, lemon juice, and olive oil.
Thanks, Dave. Now, Candy, can you tell us a little bit about what are some of the health benefits of this salad?
Well, it's a wonderful salad. In addition to its being super simple salad, these fruits and vegetables are rich in vitamins A, vitamin C, which are a huge boost to the immune system, but also it is a very high fiber salad, which means, as we know, fiber helps us stay full.
Great, so Dave, how do we make this salad? About how much prep time did you put into this?
It takes about 15 minutes to get everything prepared. The hardest part is shredding the vegetables. We use the same little box grater for the beets, the apples, and the carrots. And then the rest of it's just getting it together and mixing it up and making a little dressing and putting it on the plate.
Great.
I'm just gonna mix everything together in the bowl.
Was there any special way you prepared those beets? Just cut them up?
I just put them on the grater and shredded them up by hand. You could use a food processor if you have a grater attachment for it. So we have all our vegetable ingredients. We're just gonna toss that together. For the dressing, it's just a little bit of lemon juice and salt and pepper. So we're just gonna mix that up till the salt dissolves. And then we have some extra virgin olive oil. We're just gonna whisk that in. So we're just gonna add our dressing. Toss it up again. And then we're just gonna put that on a little bed of lettuce.
Looks delicious.
And that's it.
Well, your presentation looks great, but let's give this a try.
It is beautiful. I can get a little piece.
It's good. This might be my first time trying beets. Delicious.
If you'd like the beet, carrot, and apple salad recipe, visit watermanwellness.com. The Conree Creation Health Center has planned some interesting and hands-on classes for the community that you might want to take advantage of. Would you like to be fit for life? Then this 10-week session is just the thing. Learn the basics for combining fitness and strength building with nutritional balance. Working together, participants reach their respective health goals and stick to them. The course meets Thursdays, beginning February the 4th, and costs $50. If you or a loved one is living with a diabetes diagnosis, then you'll want to sign up for the Diabetes Self-Management class, which are held throughout the year. Local experts teach how to control blood sugar, manage medications, and how to incorporate exercise and healthy living. The cost is $35 for 5 sessions. To register for these classes and to learn about other Conree Creation Health Center programs, call the number on your screen or visit our website. We hope you've enjoyed this month's episode of Waterman Wellness, your pathway to healthy living with help from local experts. Be sure to watch for the February episode right here on Lake Sumter TV for some of the following stories. A Lake County hospital is the first in the country to offer an advanced insulin therapy for its diabetes patients. We'll explain its benefits. A Mount Dora podiatrist explains why ankle injuries are often misdiagnosed and what patients should know to avoid further damage. And our look at Heart Month will include a healthy recipe your family and your heart will love. To learn more about the experts featured in this program, please visit watermanwellness.com. Until next time, I'm Lisa Kreitz for the award-winning Waterman Wellness.